Whether the Deutsche Bank bankruptcy was just a rumor or not, whether they allow it to go down or not, it does not really matter. What matters is that you are prepared. What matters is that you do not trust any banking system with your hard-earned dollars or euros. We know the collapse of the whole financial system will happen sooner or later, so do not let it catch you by surprise. Welcome to the Atlantis Report. When debt is money, and future debt require an ever-going amount of new debt to service it, even a halt in the increase in debt, never mind a contraction, will result in instant collapse. We are at the apex of this current roller coaster ride, so total collapse of Deutsche Bank should come as no surprise. The Deutsche Bank death watch has taken an exciting turn. I knew Deutsche Bank was in trouble, and I know they are a big part of the EU. If Deutsche Bank goes down, the EU goes down, and it is going to affect everything worldwide. The biggest bank in Europe is in the process of imploding. And there are persistent rumors that the final collapse could happen sooner rather than later. Those that follow my work on a regular basis already know that this is a story that I have been following for years. Deutsche Bank is rapidly bleeding cash. They have been laying off thousands of workers, a lot of workers, and the vultures have been circling the company's executives desperately trying to implement a turnaround plan. Unfortunately for Deutsche Bank, and it already is too late. If the Deutsche Bank goes down, it will even be more catastrophic for the global financial system than the collapse of the Lehman Brothers. And oh wait, Germany is the glue that holds together the European Union. And so if the bank that is right at the heart of Germany's financial system collapses, the dominoes will likely start falling rapidly. Deutsche Bank hasn't returned a profit since 2008. Deutsche Bank is down 80% over 10 years. That's a remarkable failure. Deutsche Bank reported a net loss that missed market expectations on Wednesday as a major restructuring plan continues to weigh on the German lender. It reported a net loss of €832 million, $924 million, for the third quarter of 2019. Analysts were expecting a loss of €778 million, according to data from Refinitiv. It had reported a net profit of €229 million in the third quarter of 2018, but a loss of €3.15 billion in the second quarter of this year. That is an astronomical loss. It is impossible to lose this much money in just 6 months. Even if they had all their employees flushing dollar bills down the toilet for 6 months, it still shouldn't be possible to lose that kind of money. When investors learned that Deutsche Bank's third quarter results last week, shares of the bank went down in about 8% in a single day, so Deutsche Bank is in this much trouble, and they are the heart of Germany, and Germany is the heart of the EU. The exposures it has are an enormous risk to the global financial system. Markets are painted. Don't count on them to wake up to Deutsche Bank until it's 10 minutes after midnight. Just like all fiat currency, Deutsche Bank's intrinsic value is nil. Aside from the money laundering business with the Russians to the tune of $20 billion, what else is supporting the bank but the German government? Deutsche Bank's derivatives book is massive. Counterparty risk could bring on a contagion that will be hard to contain. If Deutsche Bank goes down, you better hope the hell you have alternative assets available, because they are connected to every GSIB, global systemically important banks in the world, including American GSIBs, so it could be entirely possible that the entire global banking system will become insolvent overnight. The derivatives exposure would probably ignite a global daisy chain of bank destruction and frozen liquidity. There's not enough money in all banks worldwide to compensate for 700 trillion rotten debts. Renowned geopolitical and financial cycle expert Charles Nenner said, "If there was ever a global canary in the coal mine warning for the financial system, it is Germany's Deutsche Bank." Late last year, Nenner predicted if Deutsche Bank stock went below $8 a share, you should be worried. Today, Deutsche Bank stock hit all-time lows and now sits around the $6.93 per share level. If it breaks below $6.40, it can go out of business. So, it's a dire situation. The IMF from his side called Deutsche Bank the most systemically dangerous bank in the world in 2016. If Deutsche Bank does break $6.40, do we get a daisy chain of default around the world? Nenner says, it is a perilous situation. I don't think Deutsche Bank is the only one. They just got caught. I think if you look at the balance sheets very closely with other banks, especially Europe and Italian banks, you will see a lot of troubling signs also. I don't think it's only Deutsche Bank. It's much more. If it breaks $6.40, the downside price target is zero. If everybody watches my analysis and it does go below $6.40, everybody is going to run for the exits. If Deutsche Bank goes below $6.40, its massive derivatives book will begin to implode, putting all the other banks around the world in deep trouble, especially the European and Italian banks, and as such, a systemic banking collapse unfolds around the globe. The entire electronic banking system will most likely freeze up for weeks or months. So Nenner says you just have to be in gold, not Bitcoin. Obviously, the central banks of the world will need to begin to print and print and print fiat paper money out of thin air, like the world has never seen in all of recorded history. It will be Weimar on steroids. Gold's price will initially spike upward to $2,500, as it begins a long multi-year bull market. That will last out to about 2024. The Fed will need to raise interest rates, the way Volcker did, to stop people from putting all their money into gold and instead try to entice people back into their fiat paper money IOUs they print up. Bank CDs could be yielding 15% or more in 2024, and because inflation will be rising at a rapid rate because of all the money printing, our politicians in government will then do as they always do and blame all the inflation on the people living on Social Security because they are buying hamburger meat instead of maggots for protein, telling them that they must tighten their belts to control inflation. So government politicians will put even more chains on the CPI, but absolutely no chains on the banksters who just got trillions and trillions and trillions in free money to bail out all their Ponzi derivative scheme banks. So it will be the ordinary people who suffer under the inflationary effects of a massive bankster bailout. If we are lucky, we will get a 3.5% cost of living adjustment when the actual inflation rate is exploding past 25%. Because someone has to pay to help out the poor crooked evil banksters. The reality is Deutsche Bank is and has been dead for quite some time. The only question is, who wants help bury it? Germany. It doesn't have the GDP to handle it. China. They're buying gold. The ECB. They're printing money just to stay afloat. The United States. Ditto. This is going to end in only one way. A global currency reset. There is no other way out of this debt bubble. Delay, delay, the delay is not an economic strategy. Neither is printing money for eternity. As I have detailed during the past several years, the plans are in place to replace the current fiat system. I know it. You know it. And President Trump knows it. We are just one event away until everyone knows it. Deutsche Bank could be the one thing that triggers the switch? I have to wonder if Deutsche Bank is the sacrificial lamb now. I think the global banking cartel's problem is that they are bound to the corpse they murdered. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.